Let us take the bread in our hands. For I receive from the Lord what I also pass on to you, that on the night he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Shall we do together? Eat the bread. Shall we take the cup, please, in our hands? In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "The cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me." Shall we partake? For the word of God says, "For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you will proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Our loving and gracious Father, we remember what you have done on the cross. Not only, Lord, we remember the importance of that, but the implication and the impact of that redemption that you have shown, demonstrated on the cross. You have given fully your life as a sacrifice for our sins. Loving Father, we thank you. You are the example. We are thinking of that, Lord, of your humility and obedience to your Father. May we do so by your grace. May we emulate the example of our Lord Jesus Christ to be truly servant of God. I pray for my brothers and sisters here, Lord, gathered together in this place. Continue, Lord, to strengthen the inner man, blessing us with every good gifts from above, so that we may be able not only to fulfill our calling till the last breath we have in this life, in this earth, but our lives can be truly become an instrument of impacting lives of people out there, especially our co-pastors and friends that really need help by your grace. Thank you so much. We will accomplish greater things, Lord, by your empowerment to us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Amen. Okay.